First of all, Rob, congratulations on a wonderful performance. There's a real subtlety to your performance here, and I think a lot of the best actors say that it takes more confidence to do something like that. Would you feel, you know, moderately less pressure this time out after tackling the Twilight franchise and the fans that come with that?
There's like a different type of pressure because everyone's, you know, because the Twilight movies do so well, and then everyone's like, oh, you know, to the most important thing to a lot of commentators is how much money your movies are making. It's totally crazy. But yeah, I guess it's a different type of pressure. But doing this, it was such a relaxed movie to make, and I felt very protected and in my performance and stuff that I wasn't too worried about it.
There's a real emotional density to this character as well, given the tragedy that he goes through in the first few minutes of it. Was that something, you know, satisfying to get your teeth into, to get really stuck into the role?
Yeah, I mean, that was one of the most terrifying things about it, because you've got to kind of establish so much in such a tiny, tiny period of time. And then I was worried that people wouldn't really pick up on why this guy is the way he is for the rest of the movie, because it's basically, you have a terrible beginning, and then he's pretty much has a lot of good experiences afterwards in a row, but like you can't fully appreciate them as good experiences because they're all tinged with horrible like heartache and depression and grief. And so, yeah, that was one of the main worries about the part.
And how does Francis Lawrence, obviously, he's done a couple of very CGI heavy movies before, this kind of fanboy movies, and he's very adamant he wanted to use very little CGI in this one. So all the sets are beautifully designed and the animals are all there. It's not CGI. How much does that age your performance, coming from something with obviously using a lot more effects? When you're there, are you just in the moment straight away?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we had our base camp across there was the railway track with the real train on, and it was on this big just like this sort of embankment. I mean, there'd be the base camp on one side, and you walked over the railway track, and then you're in the 1930s. I mean, there was nothing apart from the tent, and every single extra was in authentic costumes and stuff. And my stomach is going crazy. Sorry about that.
That could be me as well.
That was a loud one.
That could be me as well.
Yeah, it was. It makes the performance very, very, very much easier doing that. I mean, you really feel like you're not even acting half the time. You're just living in the 30s.
And, I mean, chemistry isn't something you can teach. It's either there or it's not there. And at what point did you feel like you had it with Reese? Obviously, it's the backbone of the movie, that romance.
I mean, immediately, really. I mean, she's really fun and really intelligent, and it's just a great talker. And it's kind of, I mean, I got on with her immediately. I mean, as soon as I met her, really. Well, I met her again for this, because I did a movie with her ages ago. But it was all good.
I mean, they're 23 now, still very, very young, obviously. Is there anybody?
24. Almost 25.
Almost 24. I'm 29, so to me. But is there anybody you look at, you know, career-wise, that you think I really like the direction they've gone in? I spoke to Leonardo DiCaprio a while back about yourself, and he says the one tip he would give you was to just keep doing what you were doing.
That's easy
enough.
Pretty
nice compliment.
I mean, yeah, you just kind of, I guess that's the only thing you can do. You can't ever second guess an audience ever, and even though everybody tries. So yeah, I guess I am just gonna keep doing what I'm doing. That's cool.
It was a pleasure to meet you, Robert.
I do.
Good to see you again, sir.
Thanks. My name is Jacob Jankowski.
How do you do?
And this is this is Marlena Rosenblum. All right, you're a beauty. Your skin's a little dry. Maybe you should take care of that. The first thing you notice about a woman's age is her skin.
Oh, great. Just what we need around here, another lush.
Well, you're welcome. Is this the way elephants flirt?
Would you two like to be alone?